to the e-learning platform, an initiative by Science Park for Standard 6, SSC Chapter Number 14, CBSC Chapter 11, but from Standard 6 only. The topic is light and the formation of shadows. The topics which we will be covering here are shadows. You are going to play game. Then we are going to understand about electromagnetic spectrum. Then sources of light, types of objects, then propagation of light, reflection of light, images in plane mirror, types of reflection, and then you are going to use your brain power. Do you know how leopard has got spots? Rudyard Kipling's storybook, that is just so stories, in particular how the leopard got its spots, in that he has written that after so many days the animal saw great high tall forest full of tree trunks. It was exclusively speckled and spotted and spotted, dotted and splashed and slashed and hatched and cross-hatched with shadows. Leopard asked them, "What is this?" They said, "That is so exclusively dark and yet so full of little pieces of light." Kids, this is just for fun. Now, we are going to understand what is the relation with light, this jungle, and spots on the leopard's whole body. Basically, this is just the story. But yes, in this episode, in this video, we are going to understand about shadows and lights. Have you seen such kind of shadow? There are shoes and the shadow of human. But where is that person? Oh, no idea. Okay, but we should not get frightened about shadows. Even though if we see at night, because there is simple science behind that. Let us see one experiment for that. You must be having such kind of solid pipe. If you hold torch and switch it on, you observe such kind of circular shadow. But now, if I change the position of the torch, I keep it on the other side and switch it on, and you observe such kind of shadow. So from one side, it is looking circular. From another side, it is rectangular. Now how, why, we are going to see. Also, there is one more experiment. Have you ever taken your hand just below the table lamp? Yes, you have seen shadow of your hand. Let us perform few more experiments and try to understand all these things. Have you played with your both hands for understanding the shadows? See here, I am going to show you few examples. This is how it is looking. Deer, reindeer, frog, or whatever you feel, you have to adjust your fingers accordingly and you will understand how we get the shadows, how we can get the shape of the shadow. Okay, so the shape of the shadow depends upon the source of light, object, and the surface on which it is performed. Okay, so with the help of such kind of experiment and your hands, you can make different shapes. You can show at home and your friends also. What is the origin of this source? From where this source is coming? So basically, we are going to understand this. There is electromagnetic spectrum which has different parts. Okay, different parts are based on their energies. Okay, so likewise, you have different parts of your home, like one is your bedroom, one is kitchen, one is hall. So likewise, you are having different kinds of waves, meaning based on their frequencies or energies. Like there is one part showing here, that is radio, meaning those frequencies are matched with our radios. So likewise, whenever we are able to see something, that comes in the visible kind of part. Okay, that's why we can see each other. Rest of the things you will learn afterwards. Now, can you tell me different sources of light? Yes, one is natural, another is artificial. okay, here is sun, lightning, then fire, then sky at night, then this is kind of an insect, this is worm, night lamp. Now this is artificial source of light, torch. Yes, light coming from your mobile screen. And the candle. We have seen sources of light. Here we will see types of objects. One is luminous and another type is non-luminous. What is the meaning of luminous? The objects or materials which emit light, meaning those which themselves are source of light, those are luminous objects. And what are non-luminous objects? The objects or materials that are not sources of light themselves. Now tell me about bulb. Bulb is luminous. Then these matchsticks. Then torch. What about tree? Is tree emitting light? Is tree giving out light? No. Then animals? No. That meaning those are non-luminous objects. Have you seen such kind of light coming through the window? Or the light coming like this? It is coming from small hole in the roof or big window. So the light rays are entering in the room. As these rays of light from the slit or the hole move towards the floor, the dust particle in their way are seen clearly. Okay? Due to these particles, the path of the light becomes visible. Path of the light meaning, jahan se wo rays aa rahe hain, wo hume clear dikhai deta hai. And we can see that as straight line. Let us perform one experiment here. Let us have such piece of cardboard. We are going to make hole at the center aur usko ek stand pe rakh denge. Okay? Aise aur do cardboard with stand hum banayenge. Theek hai? Aur ek candle lenge jalti hui jo hamare left hand side rakhenge aur hum ab kya karenge? खुद को वो होल के लेवल पे एडजस्ट करेंगे. देन व्हाट डू वी सी? लाइट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द कैंडल टुवर्ड्स अवर आई. ओके, नाउ व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, वी आर गोइंग टू शिफ्ट द थर्ड कार्डबोर्ड स्टैंड लिटिल बिट. क्या होता है उसमें? कैन यू सी लाइट इन दैट केस? यस और नो? जस्ट डू एंड ऑब्जर्व. सो जब तीनों कार्डबोर्ड एक लाइन में थे, यू कुड ऑब्जर्व द लाइट, बट जब ये शिफ्ट कर रहे तब नहीं दिख रहा है. क्यों? लेट अस परफॉर्म वन मोर एक्सपेरिमेंट. लेट अस पुट कैंडल इन अ रूम, देन वी विल ऑब्जर्व द फ्लेम विद द हेल्प ऑफ स्ट्रेट पाइप. क्या हम देख सकते हैं ये फ्लेम? यस, द लाइट वी कैन सी स्ट्रेट अवे फ्रॉम द पाइप. But now what we are going to do is, we are going to bend this pipe little bit. But still the flame or the light coming from the flame is going along some path. Okay? So that is, light travels in a straight line only. That is called as linear propagation of light. Ye aapne ek game khela hai. Ball ko wall ki taraf feko. Fir kya hota hai? Ball comes back towards you by changing the angle little bit. Okay? ये कितना होता है, क्या होता है, वो हम बाद में सोच सकते हैं. अभी यहाँ पे आंसर है, हम एक दूसरे को क्यों देख पाते हैं? क्योंकि हमें तो पता है लाइट तो स्ट्रेट डिरेक्शन में जाता है. बेसिकली द रेज ऑफ लाइट फॉलिंग ऑन एन ऑब्जेक्ट फ्रॉम अ सोर्स ऑफ लाइट आर थ्रोन बैक फ्रॉम द सर्फेस ऑफ दैट ऑब्जेक्ट. This is called as reflection of light. We see the object when the reflected rays reach our eyes. Till now we
we have understood that we can see objects because of reflection of light. Now let us try to understand how do we see images in a plane mirror. Have you observed your face when you have hold such kind of plate in front of your face? Then your image in the plane mirror, then the glass of the window of the car, in the spoon. Let us do one experiment. Stand in front of the plane mirror at your home, okay? Then look at your image in it. Now raise your right hand. Tell me which hand of the mirror image is raised. Yes, that is left one. What change do you see in the image if you decrease or increase the distance from the mirror? Is there any difference between your height and height of the mirror image? Basically, the image is as far behind the mirror as the object is in front of it, and the size of the image is the same as that of the object. Okay? Apart from the objects we see in the mirror, we see reflections of trees, buildings, and other objects in water or pond or lake also, isn't it? To understand this, let us perform one activity, but that should be done at night or in dark room. Okay? So let us assume that you are standing at the corner of one room and there is one mirror. So call your friend to play with you. Okay? Now hold torch in your hand. Okay? And the beam of the light coming from that should fall on the mirror. So what will happen? It will get reflected towards your friend. If it is not reflecting properly, so adjust the direction of the torch. Isn't it? So do you see a patch of light on the other side, that is towards your friend? Dekhte hai? Dekho karke? So the activity suggests that the mirror changes the direction of light that falls on it. Let us perform one more experiment. Okay? We will need one mirror for that. Then we will place such kind of comb, and we are not going to use all the slits form on the comb. Hum kya karenge uske liye? We will place one paper and small gap will be there on that paper. Okay? Then take the torch. Again, cover with similar kind of paper and make a small slit. As soon as we switch on the torch, one ray will go towards the mirror, and the ray which is falling on the mirror will get reflected like this.
Abhi reflection of light wagera ka use kahan pe hai? So we know that the light we see from the moon is the reflected light. From where? What is the source? Sun is the major source of light. That light falls on the moon and it is getting reflected. That reflected light we can see on the earth.
अब हमने देखा मिरर जो है वो प्लेन सरफेस है, उसको बोलते हैं रेगुलर सरफेस. ऐसे दो टाइप्स है, रेगुलर एंड इरेगुलर. जब कोई भी रेज रेगुलर या स्मूथ सरफेस पे आएंगे, देन वॉट विल हैपन? All those will get reflected. Okay? Now let us see for irregular surface, जो rough है. Okay? अब ये rays आएंगे इस पे, reflect होंगे. I am showing here purposefully one by one. So this is how reflection takes place for irregular or rough surfaces. Okay? So for smooth surface, that reflection is regular reflection. For rough surface, it is irregular reflection. So smooth surface, the reflection, there is another name, that is specular reflection, and for rough surface it is diffuse reflection. Use your brain power. First question: in which objects do we see a reflection?
How will you light up a dark room using reflected light? What will happen if an object is placed in colored light? Perform the experiment and write the observation.